有点 listed 怎么样，蛮难的，就 maintain 一下 survival。
A lot of the anything or any website you can IV.
Yes, he is surprisingly the big player not making money.
Yeah.
In fact, it's not.
Yeah, you look big, but you're not making money.
But last night,
that 60-second pitching or the...
Oh no, the 60-second pitching. And you want to do a quick demo. Ready, go.
I have a very exciting app to propose to you all, that is to green the city through the planting of a medical tree called neem. Why I say that is because, as you can see, the cities are less and less trees. What we're going to do is actually, we want to actually claim back our city by planting more green. Why we do that? Why neem? Neem is known as the miracle tree of the 21st century. You go and search in the United Nations, they have acknowledged that. Okay, so how are we going to work? We're going to actually plant trees through all avenues through the help of local authorities, namely the state government. Okay, then we can approach the housing estate, we can approach the development. How are we going to do that? We're going to partner with them to sponsor. We can even partner with NGOs. You think can do it? We can do it. We start with one housing estate. For example, Bandar Utama has 50,000 residents. We approach, just now I approached the state government, they say okay. Okay?
You do not have any transportation, you want to go from one place to another. Don't you feel have an experience at a loss? But what if there's an app whereby you turn on your mobile phone, you click on it, tell the destination, then they tell you, you put a click on it, they'll tell you that what mode of transport, what number of bus to take, and how much time roughly you can reach the place. Would that be wonderful? That is the app by which we'll be running on, trying to deliver. All you need to do is put on it, take a tablet, and then you press the destination you want from here to go to Museum Negara, they lead you all the way without the use of your car. That will basically target for a lot of students, people who do not have their own vehicle, and even tourists. From that, if then that would be a lot of opportunity to monetize as well. So that will be it. Our app has made.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Your story a bit different from at the end when you come as a targeting tourist, sorry, a student, people who have a vehicle. Because I know your story before this, so it's just about 2 cents.
Just about 2 cents, only.
Just my 2 cents. Just my 2 cents. Okay? Other than that, I'll do.
Okay.
Yours seems well prepared. Okay, 60 seconds, let's go. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Hi, I'm Lo. You see a lot of people now today, cost of living is very high. So people try to looking for the part-time money. So especially the single mother or student where they want to actually get the extra money to survive. You see, the single mother, if they go to the, how to say, to employ, get the job, so no one want to actually employ them. So I have this app actually to get vendor, merchant, and the user. User can actually advertise what they capable to do and what they want to do. Then merchant can actually employ them to get extra money like give credit or whatever things, like one credit, buy the gear or something like that. So from there, merchant can get them to actually like wash a car or do the write up or design the logo or whatever things.
Hi, my name is Bali.
Yeah, oh, time's up, sorry. Are you ready? Go.
Hi, my name is Bali. As you all know, there is a big refugee crisis going on around the world. In Malaysia, there are more than 35,000 kids which are refugees, and most of them, they don't have access to normal education, like proper one in schools, public or private school. So, one of the issues, one of the solutions was the creating communities for them. And those communities are run by UNHCR, and they are mainly run by profit volunteers. So the problem is they don't have like a consistent database, I mean, consistent number of volunteers. So the solution for that is a platform that matches volunteers to those communities, so people can go and volunteer according to the timetable. So what I need people with a technical background. So yeah, let's make it.
You go. Okay. So you guys have an idea, okay? So next week, next Saturday.
Second pitching, that means that representation with visual and all those things already.
Yes, you have to show the working prototype.
Yes, within 2 days, you have to put all your ideas into a real product to present in 2 days. Okay, so among your team member, like four of you, maybe you all have to delegate different tasks. Certain people have to do the market validation, certain people has a better technical skill, have to build the website. And then maybe some of you are very good in presentations, so have to start doing the slides and all that within 2 days. Yeah.
That's why I strongly unrecommend you all to find someone that is your friend. That you know them too well, right? You have to find someone that suits the skill that you need.
Okay.
Is there a number of ideas that can be used? It's not in much formative of like 3 or 4 words.
How many ideas you have now?
You want to vote? Then after that, we will pick.
After this order, we will stick in somewhere, then we have to vote.
Yes.
Then, at the end, how many will be chosen? Then we will form with how many teams?
10.
Depends on the total number of our participants. So let's say we have 40 people. So 4 persons in a group, then the top 10 ideas will be chosen.
Then the others is they are not chosen, then they will
have to join other teams.
To
learn.
Okay, so usually you will vote, right? Yeah, you pick, and then you find the groups or the teams that you want to go. So that's how it works. So far, I haven't seen any case that people have one idea has 20 over people or more than 4 or 5 that you want to join. Yeah. It's up to the person to decide. You decide what team you want to join. Yeah.
Who decides?
No. It's a group, right? And we're in a democratic society. Yeah. We're a democratic society.
Yeah. Very organic one. Please. Maybe you need someone that can actually do very good sales and branding. So you recruit for this kind of people to join your team.
I already seen people say who wants to join me and then nobody wants to join. I haven't seen a happy problem that they have too many participants. Yeah, I hope you learn as much as you can from him. Okay, thank you.
You know, the first thing I come here right on a Sunday and see like 60, 70 people here, I'm like, wow, what I can help you guys, and I'm going to go really casual. So let's make this a very to and fro kind of session where you ask me questions and I'll answer them. A show of hands of who is a digital marketer here? So I know who. Oh, okay. Digital marketer. Who hasn't done digital marketing before in life? Who doesn't know what SEO means? I still don't know. Okay. A little bit about me. I'm just going to go through a bit about me. This is a slide from somewhere else, so don't bother about it. Okay. My name is Ruben. I'm a music producer then marketer. So if you go to my site, right, rubenchen.com, you can read a bit about me if you want to. But don't do it now. Okay, I'll tell you about myself. So I started this place called Cat Studio. It's a music school. I'm a musician. That was like 8 years ago. And we grew our school from 10 people to about 400 plus people in just a year. Alright? Growth hacking and all the terms and all that, right? So that's Cat Studio. I also run an online publishing site where we publish articles. It's like a magazine but done online, right? And we monetize from around the world. Okay? And then the past 2 years I've been running a marketing firm called Cat Insights. Now if you wonder why Cat, when we started our studio called Cat Studio, right, it's creating artistic talents. A lot of people think it's cat, you know, but... Okay, so this is my marketing firm, and I begin teaching in places like Switch, Apple, and all that, and also places like this. Any of you have seen me before? Oh, no? That's depressing, man. Anybody here are musicians? Musicians. Okay, nobody musicians here. Okay, as a musician, I sell music, you know. Any of you buy music? Be honest with me. Any of you buy music?
No.
Used to download. You see? You heard me already, you know. Okay, so I tried selling the most hardest thing to sell online, music. So how do you sell music? Can someone give me an answer? How do you sell music online? I'm not an artist. I'm not famous, you probably don't know me. I'm not an artist, I'm not a singer. How do you sell music online as a music producer?
iTunes.
What do you buy?
Sometimes.
Training. YouTube is okay. So there are many ways. I mean, the bottom line is many ways to sell things online. YouTube, you're right. iTunes, Spotify, and a lot of things. So I'm really trying to connect with you guys here, like, see how I can help you in terms of selling things online or marketing things online, lah. Right? All right. Lola is a forum, by the way. Lola is a forum, right? And back like 6-7 years ago, right, there's no online marketplace, like, very little Muda and all that, just nothing wrong. And the only place you sell things online, right, is Loya. There's things like garage sales and all that. I think some of you would know, alright? Okay? So a lot of things online for musical items, physical items, from this and that, da-da-da-da. I even saw headphones online, I even saw that thing, that jam thingy. Right, because my dad runs a antique shop. Alright, so I sold a lot of things online. Okay, I like to think I'm a guru in selling things online, that I understand what everyone to buy, but I'm not. So if you're hoping that I am a guru to teach you how to sell and all that, no, I'm sorry, but I'm a work in progress. Okay, but then the conclusion is what I've learned, right, is that the best thing to sell online are digital products. Anybody here selling physical products online? Can I know what you're selling online?
Gifts.
Gifts, okay. Anybody else?
Supplements.
Okay, I've sold. There's nothing wrong about selling physical things online. But can you tell me why it's bad to sell physical things online? And I try to avoid it at all times.
Gift stock.
Alright, that's one. What else?
Delivery,
yes. What else?
Competition.
Competition is digital products for competition.
GST,
okay, it's true, you know. So there's a lot of things, a lot of reasons why I try to avoid selling physical things online, and things like that are like, you know, inventory issues, right? When I sold things, I sold musical items online. So I bought, you know, like, let's say you sell a Seiko watch, and then the next month a new brand comes up, a new model comes up. What happens to your watch? You have to sell at a lower price today. Right? That's also happened with physical products. They send you a bag, you have to pay off 2 or 3 times per year. Alright? So there's a lot of things and a lot of negative reasons why we shouldn't sell physical things online. But again, it's not wrong to do so. There's always workarounds. Yeah? But I'm just saying that I prefer to sell digital products online. Okay? Okay, but today it's not about me, so I'm going to ask for myself, it's about you and how I can help you. Alright? Now I'm going to skip to another slide. I want to go through a bit of pitching as well. Okay, before I go to the marketing part, right? Dr. Long has gone through the business model canvas, if you like.
Yes.
Okay, I'll skip there. Okay, I don't know the format of the pitching next week, but I'm going to share a few things with you on sales. Okay, now what's the number one reason enterprises or businesses fail? Okay, the number one reason that a company fails is because of the inability to sell products in quantity great enough or speed fast enough to capitalize the enterprise. Agree? Okay, bottom line is sales. Right now. How you have money? What else? Okay, I sort of agree to that way. Yeah, so that's correct. The number one thing that investors will ask you is how much you made last month, right? Because investors want to make money off you. Think of it as it, right? They don't care how cool your product is or how wonderful it is. All they care is about money, right? Of course, there are some investors who care, oh, maybe your product same size, I like it, I okay lah, I invest into it, right? Okay, so who here are not salesmen and have never sold before in his life? Can I see a show of hands? Have never sold before in life. Let's be honest, I understand. Let's be honest. I've never sold anything. I don't think I can sell. I'm not a salesperson. I hate it. Anybody? Okay, we have one, two, there. So all the rest are salespeople. Huh? Let's be honest. Okay, the fact is, right, a lot of people in startups and tech startups, right, they refuse to see themselves as salespeople. Like, they think the sales word is an evil word. Agree? Okay, I say sales are evil, like, you sell people. Right? But the fact is, right, we are all selling every day, you know. Alright, I'll give some examples. Who likes the iPhone and who likes the Samsung phone? Can I see who likes iPhone first? iPhone supporters. Why buy iPhone? Okay, why buy China phone? Why?
What do you want to use the phone for?
I want to call, I want to WhatsApp, I want to text my buyer.
Buy iPhone.
Buy iPhone, huh? One more.
Without using your Uber.
But I got Uber.
Yes, your Uber. Definitely, it's true, there's one alternative. If you like to have some savings without spending so much and you utilize the transportation, public transportation, that would be $100.
So what happened there is when I rejected him, I said, oh, but what did he do? He agreed first, right? So that's the step to take, you know. And then he went along to make the direction of the objection. Right? He said, yes, I agree. You have Uber, but what happened? Alright? Okay, so what's next?
Bye
bye. Okay, you see, so that's the little steps I take to do sales, right? It's so easy actually, it's easy to follow, right? And what you have to do is to agree to disagree. So when I say it's expensive, you say, oh, I agree with you, it's what? And then da-da-da-da-da, right? So a lot of startups, when they do pitching on that, right, they straight away like, no, it's too expensive, you think wrong already, and they. And it creates a kind of tension between you and the investor or judge. Nah. Alright? Thank you so much, yeah? Thank you. Give a round of applause. Understand? So it's a platform for you to go and teach things and all that. Right? Now, I've met many people right in my line of work right that ask me, Ruben, I want to do YouTube. YouTube can make a lot of money. Who here is making money on YouTube? Oh, I understand. Nobody, yeah? Okay, but you know YouTube can make money, right? Alright? So a lot of people are chasing that route, oh, I want to become a vlogger, I already have vlogged myself, I want to do this, do that, and earn money. But on the other hand, if you can teach me something, in Skillshare, it's very simple. All you have to do, right, is upload something you can teach people. Alright? And all you have to do is upload like 10 minutes of video. So you all have handphone today, right now. You can shoot yourself teaching financial literacy. This is how you do. 10 minutes, only 10 minutes. Upload it up to Skillshare. And when someone joins your course or your sharing, you earn $10. And I'll show you why is it so easy. You earn $10. Oh, that's stupid. Are you catching my thing?
Yeah.
Right? But let's not talk about that, yeah? Let's not talk about that, okay? I didn't say that. Okay. Number two would be royalties. Who does not understand what royalties is? Royalties means, as a musician, when you put out your music and music gets played by Starbucks, by the radio, you get paid like royalties. Okay, the same thing will go for Skillshare courses. And all you need is a 10 minutes video. Alright? The bonus teacher is $50, but I'm just going to skip that. Okay, so very simple, 5 steps. First, you sign up as a teacher. I'll go through with you and show you how it's like. Okay? There's no approval thing right now. Okay, I've thought on places like Udemy, I've thought on places like a lot of places, curious. You go to any teaching site, I'm there one, you surprise me, I'll be there. Alright? But Skillshare, there's no approval one. You know some of the sites you look at your video and say, oh, you don't speak that well, you speak Malaysian English, you don't accept. Or your video is not so quality, you don't accept that. But Skillshare, there's no approval thing here. Today you upload, not okay. You know that? And then step number four, you use your digital marketing skills, right, and share your courses. Now the simplest skill to share your courses is to tell people on Facebook, hey, I came up for a course, alright, and go join them. And here's the catch, you know, when people join this course, like, all they have to pay, right, is $1. Alright, they pay $1 to join your class, but you get 10 bucks, you know.
So I pay you
and
join my course.
Like,
I earn
$9. You can, but if not IT, like, not in this building.
I pay $1, you join my course, I earn $9.
No. You can do that if you want to. You can. It's to pay $1, right? And you earn 10 bucks per user. So you have to get 10 people in the seat. Easy, no? Yes.
I don't get
Okay, Skillshare wants to grow pack their growth. So they're offering $1 trial for any learner. When some a learner Okay. Class is over. Alright? Okay? So here's some guidelines. If you really want to do this, and I encourage you to do this, right? It's just that simple. Minimum 10 minutes per class. And you can shoot this with your iPhone also. Alright? 720p is a technical term for your video lah. I'm sure most young guys know here. The HD video is 720p, the size. Alright? And then audio is clean, like how I'm speaking right now. Screencast or image is clear. So for example, if you know how to do Photoshop, you can teach as well right now. This is how I design a flower. 10 minutes. Put it up there. It's as simple as that. Then you share it on paper and say, hey guys, this is my tutorial of how to draw a flower on Photoshop. One time you join us. You think they join? Okay, right now. Okay, this is what I get a lot. But Ruben, I don't have any skills. Because I ask you this, no, I know, I don't have any skills. I'll teach them. Right? Okay. It's 1,000 layers. So, mile means 1,000. So the cost per mile is about averagely 150 USD. That's to say, for every 1,000 receipts you receive $1.50. I'm talking 1,000, you know. And 1,000 is not easy to get, unless you're someone very famous lah. Okay, I'll show you on YouTube, yeah? And you can also use this plugin I use to check out other videos and buy them also. Okay? Okay, can you give me one YouTube user who is famous one? Huh?
Sean Lee.
Yeah. This one?
It's a beatboxer, yeah.
Okay, let's look at one of his videos and analyze it, yeah? So if you do marketing on YouTube, right, you want to use these techniques as well, also. Anyone? PPAP Beatbox. I hate the song, by the way. Okay, there you go. He is doing his nonsense. Okay, see up here? This is how much he makes on this video. 380 USD. Yes.
Accumulated.
Yes. Okay, I'll teach you how to get this thing here also. This thing is called VidIQ. If you are on your computer right now, go and search on Google Chrome or VidIQ Chrome or VidIQ YouTube. That is one. This is the one. Okay? VidIQ Vision for YouTube, go and click it and download it as an extension. Now this tool is very useful. Alright? There's a paid version also, but the free version is enough lah. Alright, I'll tell you why it's so useful. Yeah. VidIQ, this is the one. Yeah. So once you add it on to Google Chrome, you probably have to refresh your Google Chrome, right? And then when you go to any YouTube videos, you'll see this little extra thing here. Okay? So this guy earns about 380 for 2.3528 views. Okay, let's compute his earnings and see. 2 by 3, 5 to 8, divide by 1,000, we times by 150, about that. Understand? Okay, what questions do you have so far from here? Yes.
What if you try to monetize, but your video, some of these are chip-locked one? It's copied, the pirated one.
Okay, good question. Okay, let's assume all of us here today, right? We quite lousy, like, nobody knows us, we're commoners, right? What kind of videos can you do today that can go up like 200,000 pieces tomorrow. Okay, let me bring a question. Let's say today, right? I give you a challenge, right? I want you to create a video that tomorrow, right, 200,000 pieces like this.
Cool.
What video will you do?
He's right. I'll show you. I prove it to you. All right. Hey, don't be your own porn. Don't go and think about the stuff. Go and steal someone else. All right. I'll show you.
Is this session recorded? No. Okay. In Malaysia, it's called scolding.
Oh, okay. No.
Yeah. Prove it to you. Okay. I want you to see how many views they have. I'm going to off my ad blocker to see whether they have any ads or not. Yeah? I'm going to refresh that again. Okay, let's not see. Okay, you see, there's 2 million views, you know. You get the point. Understand? So that's the fastest easiest way you can use on YouTube. So today, if you're into what we call black hat marketing, you want to use this kind of techniques to rank your websites to get VCs. This is the way to do that. But the quality of people that come to your site are all lousy people like this. But you see, Malaysian people, teruk. Anybody who are there. But you see, the views are all right. Imagine your CPM on this thing, 150, every 1,000. How much you earn a day? Okay. Or then 4,000? Yeah? Your video, let's say uploading a video and put it in. So let's say I upload a video here. Any videos? Let's see wrong videos. Okay, so I'm gonna upload this one here. Oops. Oh, yo, what the fuck? Wait, I'm trying to upload. Okay, you upload a video, right? And then what you do is you put up your text here, all the text up here. See, I just copy and paste that. Easy enough. Yeah. Okay? It's best to be related though. Because if you're not related, then people will just like close in. Yeah. Can. Okay, YouTube, a bit about YouTube, right? The way you're gonna rank your videos, right, is simple. Let's say your keyword, okay. Who does not know what keyword means? Keyword, no? Okay, you know keyword. So. Okay, let's say your keyword is how to make pizza. Okay? Let me show you. Okay, let's say your keyword is how to make pizza. So how you rank a YouTube video is very simple. How to make pizza. Okay, let's say this is your keyword. Then only you put your stuff. Lesson 1 or whatever. Okay? In your descriptions, this is what you can do as well. How to make your pizza. You put the keyword twice there. Alright? And then in your tag list, you also put that same keyword, how to make pizza. Okay? And within a few days, I guarantee you, your video will be up first. Okay? The problem is nobody do things like this. Okay? So if you want to do things like this, and then very important thing is if you're promoting something, let's say you have a Skillshare video. Let's assume you have a Skillshare video or something that you're selling, let's say you're selling Pizza Maker. Alright? Can we assume that you're making Pizza Maker? So Pizza Maker, let's say your site is pizzamaker.com. Let's just for example okay. You want to put your link above the poll. We call this above the poll. Now this is a very common mistake made by a lot of marketers. I'll show what I mean. Okay, if you go back to my micro key review, is it this one? If you go back to my video here, you see that I put the link above the poll. A lot of people, they write their story first and then they must open up to see the links down there here. Yeah, this kind of simple mistake, right, will actually cost you a lot of dropouts. And with this little trick here, I got a lot of click-in bridges like that. So anybody can tell me what is this link here before I open it up? The link here? Yeah. just for the fun of it.
Website, landing page?
Nope.
Channel?
Okay, those who don't, go ahead. Those who don't know, what do you think I'm doing here?
Affiliate.
Who doesn't know what affiliate means? Affiliate, okay. See, when someone goes to my video to watch this thing, right, there are probably people who want to buy that thing. Every night. Like what I do, I mean, there's many ways to market online. But the one I just showed you, these people who come to my site, I mean, my YouTube video to watch the thing, they are already interested in that thing. They just want to see how it's used, lah, whatever. When they click on this link, they'll jump into Amazon FBA. Okay? And when someone...
Yes. Playlist, playlist is very dangerous. If I put in playlist and then I delete, my video also get deleted.
Playlist,
I know. Let's say playlist 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 videos, right? Uh-huh. If I go and remove the playlist from my video from the playlist, suddenly I found my video also deleted. That's what happened to me.
I think I deleted the video.
Okay.
Any questions to me so far?